Welcome back to WagerTalk.com. We're heading to the SEC. We've got a big one. Mississippi State and Georgia, two teams undefeated. I don't know that anybody thought both of these teams would be undefeated moving into week four. Big upset last week, Ralph. This is going to be Preston's best bet. So we're going to start with you. Big upset last week over LSU. Obviously, we're seeing some movement in the lines. You tell us about, you know, the movement and what we've got here.
You know what? Preston was playing games at the win, and I saw him on Sunday, and we were talking about this game. And, you know, I made this line Georgia 10. I truly feel this is a complete overreaction to Mississippi State's route over LSU. You're now going on the SEC road. Fitzgerald is a quality quarterback for Mississippi State. But again, he only had three or four road games last year, and nothing to the playing up to this type of defense that Georgia has. So the number's clearly short for me. For me, it would be take the home favorite or nothing at all.
Preston, one of my favorite sayings, and I do it, you know, 1,000 times a year during the course of the season, is no team's ever as good as their best effort, or are they as bad as their worst effort. They're somewhere in between. Everybody saw the best effort last week from Mississippi State against LSU, and the fact that it was on TV, it was magnified, and they made LSU look bad. I mean, they rolled them by 30 points, and LSU was a team, a lot of hype. You know, the coaching change, you know, get past the Les Miles era, and that the offense was going to be exciting, bringing in Matt Canada, and then they just get waxed the way they did. How do you look at this game and break it down from there?
Yeah, for one, I mean, the first thing I do with any game is I check where my number's at after I make adjustments over the weekend. And I was similar to Rolf, had it at 9. I mean, he's 10. I have it 9. I mean, I give 4 points of home field advantage for Georgia. A line of 4.5 essentially implies they're even on a neutral field. And that's not even, you know, regarding the spot that this is probably Mississippi State coming off their biggest win in 10-plus years as a program. And, you know, going on the road, I don't get how this number is so low. So if it gets me, so be it. But I love the fact that they're coming off of the LSU win. I don't think LSU, now everyone's seeing how poorly BYU's offense has been since that 27-0 BYU win. And now looking at it this on this side of it where they just got clobbered by 30, I think, you know, maybe LSU isn't that good in the end of it. I mean, they're always better than average, but they're not going to be great or elite now in this season or in the SEC. And, you know, on the flip side, you have a team, I think, in Georgia. I was just knocking Notre Dame for losing to them, but that's because they had, like, you know, a turnover advantage, this and that. They're going against a guy starting his first game as quarterback. But I actually like Fromm. He reminds me a lot of Trevor Siemian. People say, like, why is he so good for Denver? He doesn't have, like, the physical tools. I mean, he's a not only a good decision maker, but he's a very quick decision maker. And that's exactly what I saw against Appalachian State when Eason went out, the big touted Georgia quarterback who can throw it 60-plus yards. Fromm went in and just looked like he was on his toes, just quicker. Better decision maker on top of it, but just a quicker decision maker, which at the college level, and we've seen, I think, with Siemian, in NFL too, if you can just make decisions that are plus EV and do them quicker than someone else, it doesn't matter how far you can throw it. I think he's a better quarterback for Georgia anyway, is what I'm getting at. They played Sanford last week. They essentially had 2 weeks to prep for this game in a really good spot in a Kirby Smart defense that he's a former defensive coordinator under Saban at Alabama. I think it could get really ugly. And if Mississippi State keeps this close, you know, in the end, let's say it is a close game, whether Georgia covers or not. If Mississippi State keeps this close or even wins, then, like, watch out. Like, this Mississippi State team's absolutely for real. I got to bet that they're not. But if they aren't proving me wrong, then you have to give them respect.
Yeah, I like the Georgia defense. I think we're going to see, as we talked about in the Notre Dame video, as we move later in the season, our stock's going to go up on Georgia. And I think the combination of them being underrated right now and Mississippi State being overrated off of 1 week last week, I got to agree with you 100%. So there you have it. You got Preston's best bet. It is on Georgia. Ralph, I'm going to come back to you real quick for a promo. You do the Gridiron Guide for Wager Talk. It's up at Wager Talk for free. I like to slap Johnny sometimes, all the stuff he gives away for free. But tell us about it. It's a great publication to help you in your own handicapping.
Quite simple. Full page per game matchup. It has the ATS over-under and straight-up logs. But included in those logs are the yards per game, diff and for each team, and the turnovers, and the quarter-by-quarter scoring. So those people that want to play quarters or halves, you have the entire season in front of you as the season progresses. Year-to-date averages and you know, some great over-under logs that you can't find anywhere. Updated each week, it has about 10 categories over-under, 10 categories against the spread. That's the Gridiron Guide. And then we also do a stat comparison sheet. That's up on Tuesdays as well for free, college football and then Good News. I do all of the teams, the differences. Everyone knows whose offense is good and whose defense is good, but a true test of a team is the yards per game diff. So yards per game, strength of schedule, points per game, and yards per play diffs for all the teams in all five categories.
And that's for free, too?
It is.
I'm going to smack Johnny. All right, you got it, guys. We'll be back with more here at Wager Talk. Download that Gridiron Guide at Wager Talk and tell your friends about it as well. We'll be back with more, WagerTalk.com.